The one thing I will tell you about marriage that people don't pay attention to. I want to marry her because I love her. Shut up. I want to marry him for deen. You're not marrying a beard. You're marrying a human. It's a person. You could be religious, pray five times, and you could still hate their guts. Just because someone is practicing their deen does not make them a good person in every other way. There are plenty of people that have an anger problem and they go to Hajj every year, but they still have an anger problem. So what I'm trying to get at, Allah mentioned one thing about marriage that is on top. Number one, everything else is later. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا لِتَسْكُنُوا. This is called لَامُ التَّعْلِيلِ. He said he made you into spouses for the purpose that you could find peace. For what purpose? Say it. You could find peace.
When we're looking for a potential spouse, it's very important that we look first and foremost at a person's character. Now, when I say character, includes deen, but also something beyond deen. So sometimes when we look for a potential spouse, we might only look at surface characteristics of deen. For example, the person has a long beard and dresses a certain way, or the person or the sister dresses a certain way, and therefore we consider that that person has deen. We have to look deeper than only the external when we look for character. Character includes deen, it includes a person's practice, but it also includes a person's manners, includes how a person behaves. The Prophet ﷺ told us, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِ. So the Prophet ﷺ has actually given us a criteria to know who is the best. And that criteria is this: the best of you are the best to their families.
Number one is peace. Now, what does that mean? That means when you love someone, but you can love someone without respecting them. You can love someone without being honest to them. You can love someone without caring for them properly. You can love someone but hate their family. And all of these things, you know what they do? They take away the peace. So even if love is there, peace is not there. And when peace is not there, the purpose of the marriage is gone.
One of the mistakes we make a lot of times is that we simply look at deen or character and don't look for the other half of the equation, which is compatibility. You might have two people who have beautiful character, Zayd and Zainab, for example. Radiallahu anhum, they had beautiful character. However, they were not compatible, and so they did get divorced. And so one thing we have to also put into the equation is compatibility, and that of course has to do with many different factors. Compatibility in terms of how you personality, how you think, culture, the way you look at things, your goals, etc. But those are the two aspects that I would say: character, including deen as well as manners, and compatibility.
So when you're looking for a spouse, you're asking yourself, what is it that makes me peaceful? Mm-hmm. What is it that gives me calm? My wife, my husband, they should be my calm. When I talk to them, my stress goes down. My anxiety goes down. My anger disappears. Because all the storms in my life, my spouse gets rid of them. That's the kind of person I want to marry. Now, if you're talking to someone and already there's drama, there's already a temper problem. There's already attitude. There's already difficulty in communication. And you're ignoring it because you love him too much. Then you're not going to have peace later. You're simply not going to have it.